family went to the dog pound to find a dog.
And we went to the pound to get it, and walking around to all the dogs, I wanted a small dog, and so did Erica.
So all the dogs were all barking, and the only dog that wasn't barking was Archie. And he was sitting there very quiet and didn't say a word.
At the behest of my father, we chose that one. I'm not necessarily the most pleased about it at the time, because we wanted a cute, kind of fun, insta dog.
So, from there we left, and we went to, it was Westgate, I think.
But we got Archie, and he looked, from what I understand, just like my grandfather's dog, Lassie.
Bruce went in with the kids to get some dog supplies, and I sat outside with this dog, who just sat beside me like he'd been our dog all our life, and he just sat there on the little leash. And while I was sitting there, a lady came by, and the lady said to me, she goes, "Oh, what a nice dog, what's his name?" And I said, "Well, I don't know, we just picked him up, we just got him a while ago." She said, "Oh, he looks just like my old dog named Archibald."
And me and my sister, like, really dug Archie comics at that period of time, too. Still kind of do.
We had all kinds of silly names coming out, Puddles, and I can't remember the other names. Anyway, we said, what about Archie? And Archie stuck. And that's how we got his name.
It all fit together, and we took Archie, went into Freddy, which was the car that we had at the time, and then drove home with our dog and my favorite car that my family ever owned.
Archie became quite a member of the family, and came upon me to walk him. So every morning I got up, no matter what time my day started, and got and walked Archie. And there was a time where we used to have a doggy play group at the local school, where there was about a dozen dogs who would play regularly and run around in circles. And without a doubt, Archie was the herder of the group, and definitely the fastest dog in the group. He wasn't the biggest, but there wasn't a dog that could catch Archie.
So he's a very athletic dog, very beautiful.
He was a very fast dog as a child. I remember being amazed by that. I remember asking my parents who ran faster, Donovan Bailey or the dog. They said the dog, and that blew my mind and made me love Archie.
Archie was also a wild dog. There was one time where I was backpacking with Archie in the woods. I was about 2 hours into the mountain, and then all of a sudden Archie disappeared. Couldn't find him. I think he chased a deer, ran off, never came back. Well, he likely came back looking for me, couldn't find me, followed my scent back, but in the wrong direction, to the car, I later found out. So I hiked, not knowing where Archie was, all the way back to my car, and guess who was sitting right beside the car? Archie, waiting for my return. And from that point forward, we realized that Archie needed to be a dog on a leash at all times.
And then another time we were hiking, we got to the top of the mountain. It was really exciting. James and I were both really young, and we were sitting down for lunch, and we had a bagel out, and I forget who it was. I think it was James or me. Someone threw the edge of the bagel over the cliff, and Archie chased after it and jumped off the actual edge of the cliff.
I'm on the top of Mount Phelps. In a moment, I'm going to show you where Archie chased a bagel bit that James threw off the cliff.
And basically just disappeared. So we all freaked out because we thought he had literally just jumped off a mountain.
And he jumped off and went down there and was able to climb up that cliff with his claws. Pretty impressive dog.
And I guess we didn't see what happened, but we saw him. All we saw was him clawing his way back up because it was like probably about this deep with trees everywhere. But he was okay because he's a tough dog. But he did some funny things when we were hiking. One time we were hiking, Dad attaches him to like his waistband of his knapsack. So he ties his knapsack like this and then attaches him with a carabiner to the waistband. And I guess he saw a squirrel or something and bolted forward. My dad did one of these. Because we all like seeing my dad get hurt. It was really funny for everybody.
Archie was the great escape dog. He was a wild dog at heart. He needed to be left in our backyard in a locked fence at all times, because if he got out, he'd disappear for hours. He'd run through the neighborhood, chase squirrels, chase whatever he could. Friendly as can be, he made lots of friends as he roamed throughout the neighborhood. But then we have to get into our car and try to track down Archie. This happened dozens of times as Archie escaped and ran around wild.
Yeah, Archie was really good for hiking. We took him a lot of trips. very active. He liked to kind of escape, but he always came back. Like, even at the cottage, he escaped, and we just kind of trusted that he would come back.
Oh, no, he did one of those times again where he ran away at the cottage, and Bruce would always say, oh, he'll be fine, he'll come back, and sure enough, he came back, but he had about, I think he had about 5 or 6 little quills stuck in his face, and I believe Bruce had to take him into the vet into Smith Falls and take them out, and apparently you can just cut them in the barb and hooks, but yeah, he wasn't fazed at all by these things sticking out of his nose.
When we were at the cottage, Archie would routinely escape as well, but then you go back in the woods and chase and harass the poor wild animals, the raccoons, the porcupines, the deer, they're back there.
He had a few idiosyncrasies. He didn't like loud noises. He wouldn't, he got very scared with fires. He wouldn't go near campfires. And he didn't play. I think the only time he ever played was when we chased him around the yard. I think we played the chasing game with him and he used to run, but he wouldn't fetch a ball.
But also type of dog that would come up to you and lick you if you were sad. So that's cool. Very dependable, very friendly, very quiet. One of the best behaved dogs I've ever met. And I would hope to have my own dog someday that is just like Archie.
Here's my dog, Archie. Archie, say hello. Oh. Want to show them the YMCA?
As Archie got older, he became turned kind of like a wise old dog, where he got slowly blind and kind of deaf.
He was never allowed to come upstairs, and he wouldn't come upstairs. He was really good, and the only time he ever, we'd catch him, I think, twice when we came in the front door, and he came, like, booting it down the stairs. We knew he'd been upstairs on the bed.
Old, senile, and crazy, but very lovable and gentle still.
He stares at me.
Do you think Archie and Bailey would have got along?
Yes, they would have loved each other. Because he loved little dogs, actually. Remember that? He used to like little dogs.
Okay? Okay, okay, okay.
Oh, yeah, and she would have liked him. He would have liked him too.
Archie was very good. He was very, very loyal. I miss him. I remember when he was really old, we just lie in the carpet cuddling together, and you know, he was just a really, really good dog.
Anyway, he was a really good dog. He was a good hiking dog.
Do you miss Archie?
Yes.
Archie was an important part of the family. We all loved Archie, and we miss him dearly.